Well, good morning, folks. Hey, me and Logan, we on the golf cart. It's like 100 degrees today. I've been busy. I had my lot, pines cut out my lot. We got to clean it up. They got to haul them off. I might build me another house one day over there. I don't know, but I got tired of all them big pines. So we got to do a little cleaning up, a little trimming. But we working on our lot next door. Took some time off. I ain't been fishing probably until today. I ain't been fishing over a week. I've been dealing with the cleaning a lot and running Logan on the golf cart. But today, I'm going to show you again, maybe a little slower, how I clean my crappie. We went fishing, I went fishing for a little bit, and Logan just marking. But anyhow, I used a flutter spoon, caught three real quick on the flutter spoon. Then I went and see if I could catch a couple of crappie. And we caught, didn't have any minnows. The weather's too hot for minnows right now. Can't keep them alive. But hey, I'm going to show you again, slower, how I clean my crappie down here at the shed. It's my wood shed. I got a stainless steel table set up down here. I still got a huge pine right here, and it throws trash all down in here while I try to clean my fish. But we can't get that one. It's too close to the building. But anyhow, hadn't run the boat in about a week. Still got my other boat for sale. I hadn't really put it up for sale yet. Man's supposed to be looking at it, but 2 months has been sitting at his shop, and he has yet try to fix it. It's got a in the fuel regulator. It's got some parts that was bad, and they're rebuilding it or going to. Said it wouldn't take but an hour, but I'm not gonna call any names. But he's had it for 2 months, and I still ain't got my boat back. So hopefully, before winter, I'll get my boat back, and I want to sell this good boat. Nothing wrong with that boat. What happened was the motor was running out of gas at full speed after a couple miles. It was like it wasn't pumping enough gas, and it was consume all the gas that was sucking up to it. So they come up to the point that it probably was in the fuel regulator. I put a fuel pump on it. That didn't fix it. You run it all day long, half speed. Three-quarter speed, but when you try to go wide open for about a mile or so, it runs out itself out of gas, but it'll crank right back up and come in, no problem. So it's nothing major, but just got to get somebody to do it. When they get fixed, they got a brand new trailer, got some new carpet, not totally new carpet, but places where the carpet was bad, replaced the carpet, and should be a really good setup for somebody. I'm gonna show you now how I clean my fish. Y'all bear with me a little bit. All right, folks, we caught 9 crappie. The smallest one's 14, the biggest one is 16 inches long. And we caught 4 stripers. One of them was a little one I caught fishing for crappie. I threw him back. But we caught 3 stripers on the flutter spoon. They're good sized stripers. That one right here, we'll measure him right quick. That striper is a 26 inch striper, so that's a good one. But hey, we didn't have any minnows. We had jigs only and a flutter spoon. And I went out, hadn't been in a week or so. Hey, and we caught a nice mess of fish. Them was nice crappies. Every one of them clear water crappies. Well, I'm gonna show you now. And I've done fish cleaning videos again before, excuse me. But we're gonna do one again. People like to watch that. Preferably, if I'm going to eat fish with bone in, I scale them, cut the heads off, and on fish this size, I fillet the sides off, and I like that backbone piece, and I pull the fins out. Well, we're going to do the first one like that. I might fillet one, just fillet the skin off. I use a Dexter 7-inch knife, and I use a regular fish scaler from Walmart. I got rusted up with all the rain we had. But that's about a 15 inch crappie right there. About 15 inches. And I don't know if you can see them or not. Probably can't with this camera, but that's a nice mess of fish. right. When I'm scaling, and a lot of my people that like my fish, they like to fry them with the bone in. I like them both ways. Some days I'll fry them with the bone in, some days I'll fillet them. What I'll do is I'll cut the scales off. Then I'll take the knife, and I'll go on each side of the fin, cut down the back fin. Now, this Dexter's a stiff knife. I bought other knives, thought it was going to be better, but they're not stiff enough. And I just push up on that fin, and it pops out. Now, the bottom one's a little bit harder to get out. Top one will pull out like that. So most of the time on the bottom one, I'll just, and I'm coming back toward my hand, but I've done it so much I don't cut myself. And I'll cut that fin off like that. Now, what I like to do at this point is I take 45, back the knife down to the bone, grab a hold of the mouth, turn my knife, and kind of go out like that, right down the bone. Now, if you don't want the rib cage, you can cut on each side, V it out, but I leave the rib cage on, and that way you can eat the rest of this little meat on the side. That's what I'm talking about right there. You got a fillet of crappie. And I do both sides. I go down. Now this one you got to be very careful or the backbone will break on you. You got to kind of ease it out. Can't put a lot of force. And you, once you get along that bone, you're going out. You got a nice piece of filleted crappie. All you got is the rib cage. Like I say, I cut on each side if you don't want rib cage. I like the skin on my fish, and if I'm going to fry the skin on my fish, I like cornmeal or a mixture of cornmeal, house ostrich, or you can use flour mixture. Now, we're going to do one, my fillet method with the skin on. I don't even scale them. I just go down, come right out. All right, at this point, I just go out with it. And we got skin on, scales on. Then I'll go at the end, right between the tail and the skin, the meat, and go right out. Work my way right out like this. You cut the skin off. Them scales keep the blade from coming out. You can't scale them and do that. You got to leave skin on. Then I like to, when I'm doing them like that, I kind of cut on the back of the rib cage, like this. And then you got a piece of meat with no bone. That's what I'm talking about, piece of meat with no bone. And if you're going to do them like that, you can put them in the mustard like I've done that video, and then put house ostrich or flour or mixture. I don't much like cornmeal if I'm going to do them without the skin on. I like cornmeal on them with the skin on. That's my preference. Okay, I'm going to do the other half the same way, real slow. I hope the camera's getting it. That's hard to tell when you do it. Work out. Same way. Now this piece here, you notice I got the fin still on this. But if you like the backbone piece with the fin on it, you can cornmeal that right there and fry it. And it's really good. You can notice the fins. A lot of people do that now. I know some of y'all say yuck, but a lot of people eat the fins, crunch them up after they fry. They're good. Well, I'll do the same thing. I'm cutting the doggone rib cage and skin off right down the side. And we come up with the back, with the skin, and nothing but scales. If you don't want to waste the rib cage, you can leave the rib cage on just like that. So that's two options. Now, that being said, that was the crappie. Now we're going to do the small rockfish. on the rockfish, I don't scale them. I go down, I go along the backbone out to the tail. I go down right there behind that fin, right on down the backbone out to the tail. You can keep the this piece here for a striper if you like. I don't, but it's okay to eat, just like the crappie. Then I go down to the bone area right there, rib cage. Take my knife and turn it. Hold on to the piece right here with the rib cage. I hold on with that. Then you got the skin off it, see? Now, I like to trim the dark meat out. I just have. Always done it. A lot of people talk about bleeding them and stuff like that. I don't bleed them. I don't go through all that mess. I just trim that out. Now, if you want a piece of baked fish, you got it. If you want to fry them, you cut that piece off. You got two pieces right there. Okay, let's do the other side. Same way. Go down behind the rib cage to the skin. Turn the knife. Work out. That's how easy it is. Hard to beat the old Dexter. Cut him, you got two pieces, see that? We'll do the big rockfish. Old big one. He's a good one. Go down right behind the head. Turn the knives and hold on best way you can and ride out along that backbone. See that? Turn it around. Back behind the bone, the head, right down the backbone again. Right out. Uh-oh. All right. We're getting a mess here. Let's see if we can't spray the table off a little bit and not get it on the camera. Them stripers are really nasty when it comes to cleaning. When the big ones like that, I normally just go straight across about halfway down to the back and cut it off in two pieces. If you want one piece to bake or something like that, you just take your time and trim it all out. But that's the way I do it on the big ones. I don't mess with the rib cage. Some people say I'm wasting, but I just don't do it that way. You do it the way you want to. This is my way. You got a good chunk of meat, fry up real good right there. All right. I'll take this other piece, trim the dark meat out. As much as you can. Slice it again, ready to go. Now, I'll try to do this in one piece. Trim around the rib cage. And I'll start at the back, come all the way up. Till I get to that point, then I go down. You can go all the way up that point if you want to, but I'll go down and meet it halfway. And, didn't quite get it good enough. Okay. Now, trim the dark meat out. Cut it in pieces, done. All right, let's do another crappie. I'll scale them. If I'm not going to cut fillet the skin off, I'll scale them first. If I'm going to fillet the skin off, I do not scale them at all. Okay, at this point, we cut the bottom fin up on each side. I'll turn him over, cut that out. Then we'll go down beside his head, hold his mouth, right straight on out the backbone, and you got a piece of meat. Do the same thing as the other side. Right on out. That's how easy it is, folks. The more you do it, the better you get at it. And that piece of meat right there, I love the backbone piece. All right. I'll scale another and then show you one more time how I do it when I scale it. I work on both sides real good and the back real good, right behind the fins. All right. Cut on each side. Push out. See how easy that is? Cut on each side. Cut back. Go down behind the head. Hole in his mouth. And go out. Just that easy. That's all you got to do. I like to do both sides if they're powder better. If they're smaller, you can leave the backbone piece on the other half. That's the way I clean my fish, folks. We'll do one more rockfish. I didn't have but three. Go down and out. Turn him over, down to the bone and out. Go right there at the edge of the rib cage. Turn the blade, go between the skin and the meat. Swivel it around and out. See that? All you got to do. Give you rockfish and crappie on the same video. Got to love that. Hey, I appreciate all y'all watching my videos, but I am definitely going to slow down. I went fishing today and did not take the camera with me, because I knew they were going to get hot. The weather's been almost like over 100 heat index, and the cameras cannot stand it. So it ain't no need to fight with them. I know y'all going to not like getting a video up, but hey, when it starts getting cooler, maybe I'll go back to doing it. But when it's hot, I can't get much footage. I fight cameras all day. It was really nice to go fishing today and not worry about video and worrying with cameras. So I just enjoyed myself today on 4th of July. Like I said, I hadn't been in a while. Just had to get back and try it out. Now, when I scale my crappies, I start right here along the back fin, out. And then I work it all the way down to the bottom fin. I turn him over, back fin, all the way down the side. Then I'll come up the edge and get the edges of the bottom fin, work out, then I get on each side. That's the way I scale my crappie. I'll scale a couple more for you. And I work it all the way to the bottom, make sure I'm getting all the scales. Most of the time I'll just put them in a pan and it rinses them all, the scales off. My son bought me these stainless steel pans, work really well. All right, let's work one right out the back. Right down the middle, all the way to the bottom. Get the back of that fin, tail, out the back, down the bottom, get the middle, in the pan. That's how simple it is, folks. Ain't nothing to it. Old Fisherman been doing it for many years. Somebody will come up and say, oh, that's not the way to do it. I'm not telling you got to do it my way.
I'm just telling you, after so many years, this is the way I do it. If I'm going to scale them and flay the sides off and leave skin on. We caught all these crappies on the jig. Can't keep minnows alive right now. I had minnows, they all die. So that's it with minnows. Once you rinse the scales off these, them's nice crappies, folks. Them nice crappies, all of them same size. From 14 to 16 inches. Them's good crappies. All right. We'll take a crappie out, lay him down. Push the fins out, cut the bottom. I hope it's showing all this good. Then that's when I cut down behind the head, turn my knife sideways, and just go basically out to the tail. Fillet that off. See that? Can't hardly beat that. Do it again. Fine piece of meat. And then I cut the back right there at the head. And then you got another fine piece of meat. That's the one with the ribs. Let's see if we can do it with that angle. Cut on each side of the back fin. Push up, pulls it right out. Each side of the back fin. Or the front bottom fin. You got to kind of cut back on this. You got to watch your hand when you do that now. That's why I wear these gloves. All right, right down the back, right out. You got a good piece of meat. See that? That's what I'm talking about. Go down. Sometimes that backbone will break on you like that one just did. Makes it a little bit aggravating. Try to keep it intact. It makes it kind of aggravating, but anyhow, you'll see it semi-broke right there. See that? All right, got three more. Back fin on each side. Out, pull all that out. Bottom fin on each side. Bind the head down, hold the mouth out. See how easy that is, folks? This is the side where the backbone wants to break off sometimes. Didn't that time. Look at that. Huh? What I'm talking about right there. All right. This piece right here, people laugh at. Why you keep that? Because it's good. That's why. Fries up really good. Got two more left. Old Fisherman's pretty fast when it comes to cleaning fish. What I'm talking about, right there. The other side. Get the backbone. All right, last but not least. We didn't catch that many, but we caught a mess of fish. We got a mess of stripers. Can't catch five stripers anyhow. Catch 20 crappies, but we didn't catch but nine. I had to make them bite. They didn't want to bite. I had to go to the jig, but we caught nine. Hey, I'm proud of that. Didn't have to buy metals. Down the side to the head, hold the head, get along that backbone and the meat, and right out the back, out the side. See that? Same thing on this side. Now that one done broke off with. The last one's always going to mess up. But anyhow, if it messes up, all you got to do is start, go right down the side and hold it down tight to the table, right on out that way. Hey, always a way to do it. You just got to keep working and get your best, easiest way. All right, folks. Hey. Hey, glad you could be with me. Glad I got to teach you a little bit more about cleaning fish. God bless each and every one of you. And like I say, probably won't be a video coming up every week. Too hot. Cameras don't work in heat. But God bless you. Thanks for watching. Appreciate you. And old Logan, he sits on that golf cart right over there and watches me. He loves his daddy. Appreciate y'all being with me. Look at that. What? Now that's fish, ain't it?